Mason Street. Baby, but I can't take you. Oh, 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 oh. Well, I'm going way down on Basin Street, baby, but I can't take you. And the way down yonder, an ugly gal can't do.
That was the famous Chicagoans under Red Nichols' name. Boy, what a lineup. Every one of those guys was an all-star back in the late 1920s and early 1930s. Jump ahead a few years to Tad Dameron and the group that helped make bebop famous. Fats Navarro was here with his trumpet. Ernie Henry, alto saxophone, Charlie Rouse, tenor saxophone, Tad Dameron, the pianist, composer, arranger, leader, Nelson Boyd was the bassist, and Shadow Wilson, the drummer. And this was recorded in September of 1941 for the Blue Note label. This is one of my favorite Tad Dameron compositions, The Squirrel.
Thank you.
Fat Dameron and Fats Navarro and the Squirrel. And that's it for this hour, but a couple of minutes for some important messages, and then right back with hour number three. I'm Dick Buckley. This is Chicago Public Radio. With the music, it'll be in a minute. First of all, I want to clear up the thing about K and Kai. I've done this before many times, but since we're featuring K, just remember that he was born in Denmark, came to this country still just a baby, and his name was Kai. That's the Danish pronunciation of K-A-I. And but in America and going to school and everything else, he was K-A-I became K. He was K Winding. When he first started, he was the Coast Guard band during World War II. That's when I first heard him, and was intrigued with that real funky sound that he had on the trombone. I used to play the trombone, and I get a funky sound, but it was different type. Anyway, K-Wing was one of the outstanding trombonists. He came along with the Coast Guard band, then he joined the Stan Kenton band and kind of set the style for trombonists always to follow. Then he formed the duo with J.J. Johnson, K and J. And where would that have been if it had been Kai? Kai and Jai, or whatever. So anyway, all of this time his name was K. Winding, as far as Americans were concerned. So he was K. Winding, as his name was K-A-Y. But when he was with the Kenton Band, he was a featured artist with the Kenton Band, and they always introduced him as K. Winding. He did a lot of, this was when bebop was coming in, and he did a lot of recording with modern jazz groups to show the trombonists that, like, he and J.J. Johnson could play the bop things on trombone on slide and didn't have to switch to a valve. He was busy, first of all, doing some of the studio work, and then when he and J.J. began their very successful tour of the country and the world, he and J.J. broke up their group because they both had different ideas of where they wanted to go, and even though it was a successful group and they made money, it was still the idea that Jay wanted to do one thing and K wanted to do another, so they decided to split finally. And I was thinking of how many groups want to get started and become popular. And here's a group that became popular, and they gave it up because they both had different ideas of music. K formed the trombone quartet, and that's what he knew was best known for. He got lucky in that he had a hit record on the Verve label, and that's when the Kai thing came up again. He had a hit record. The disc jockeys around the country saw this strange name, K-A-I, and so they called it Kai, and he became Kai Winding. And those who picked up on his music and when it was very popular, didn't hear the K. He became Kai, and so they began to call me and tell me that I was mispronouncing his name. So I had to go through this big, long routine again about the K and the Kai thing and how it happened. We're going to, first of all, play a thing while he was before the J.J. Johnson merger. He was one of the busy studio jazz players, And the K-winning quintet was Boo Moore, who was probably closer to Lester Young's sound than any of the young tenormen at that time. Lou Stein was the pianist, Jack Lesberg bass, and Don LeMond the drummer, and Kay Winding with their arrangement of Honey. Quintet, and that was Honey. After working with J.G. and then going out on his own, he started a trombone quartet. Actually, it was the K-winning trombone sound with his septet featuring four trombones. And we want to play one of the sides with his quartet now. Carl Fontana was there, a brilliant young trombonist, and Kay gobbled him up right away. Then it was, along with Carl, there was Wayne Andre, and Wayne Andre playing the third trombone part. And Dick Lieb was there when he was fourth trombone. Actually, he played a lot of bass trombone and didn't take as many solos as Wayne Andre and Carl Fontana and, of course, Kay. Here's one of the early records by the Kay Winding Trombone Four Trombones, the personnel that we just gave you. And this is Breezing Along with a Breeze. Thank you. key with the trombones and breezing along with the breeze. This next one, Carl Fontana, who was recognized by just about everybody to be the fastest, most facile trombonist around. And so Nat Pierce wrote this arrangement and called it Captain Cutcha. You want to tangle with somebody that knows what they're doing? Then tangle with Captain Cutcha. Sounds like this. You can tell when Fontana comes in, it's just an altogether different sound. Captain Cutcha, Kay Winning's trombones. Kay decided, along with the people at Columbia, that there weren't enough people aware of trombones in modern jazz, so they decided to do a little thing to give the people a bit of instruction and a bit of trombone panorama. Thank you.
By way of introduction, this is the trombone panorama. In it, we offer you a cross-section of various styles of trombone playing throughout the past few decades. As you may be aware, trombone playing technique has come a long way in a short period of time. Not too long ago, the trombone was looked upon as a more or less clumsy instrument, good primarily for some humorous effects and for laughs in general. We'd like to start by giving you an example of this humorous characteristic of the trombone by playing a few bars of a selection which you may have heard in minstrel musicals, or perhaps you've heard it played at a concert in the park. It utilizes a slide to its fullest extent and demonstrates the comical sound of the trombone. It's called Lassus Trombone. The trombone has played a very important part in Dixieland music, or traditional American jazz, as we know it. This style of trombone playing is usually referred to as a tailgate style. The term originated down in New Orleans, where jazz was born. In the old days, the jazz bands used to participate in parades, and the bands actually would be transported through the streets in horse-drawn carriages. The trombone player would sit on the tailgate of the wagon in order to manipulate the slide more easily. Thus the term originated, tailgate trombone playing. We'd like to give you a brief example by doing some Muskrat Ramble featuring the tailgate style trombone of Carl Fontana. One of the most outstanding trombone players to come out of the Dixieland era is a fellow by the name of Jack Teagarden. We like to do his theme song, played by Carl Fontana, I've Got a Right to Sing the Blues. Duke Ellington has had many great bands through the years. He used to feature a trombone player with his band who had a very unique style. He utilized a mute and a rubber plunger to get this particular effect. His name was Tricky Sam Nanton, and we like to play a few bars of a tune he recorded with the Duke called Sidewalks of New York. Back in the late 30s and early 40s, Jimmy Lunsford had one of the most swinging bands of the day. His featured trombone player was a gentleman by the name of Trummy Young, who did an awful lot to modernize the concept of trombone playing. His style, with the tune that he used to do with Lunsford's band, Margie. The beautiful melodic and lyrical qualities of trombone playing came into prominence with the arrival of Tommy Dorsey. His name will always be synonymous with the sweet style of the trombone. Here are a few bars of his theme song, I'm Getting Sentimental Over You, played by Wayne Andre. Tommy Dorsey's era was the era of the dance bands. There were many different kinds of dance bands. Some were swing and some were sweet. Some of the sweeter ones we used to refer to as the Mickey Mouse bands, and some of them really used to take advantage of the trombones, slipping and sliding on the endings. We'd like to give you an example of this style by having Carl Fontana do a little bit of Swing and Sway with Sammy Kaye. Perhaps the most successful dance band of all time was headed by a trombone player. Besides playing the trombone, this gentleman was a fine arranger. He was a tremendous organizer. We'd like to pay tribute to the late Glenn Miller by playing his theme song, Moonlight Serenade, the way his trombone section used to sound. The concept of jazz trombone playing started to change in the 40s. A fellow came up from Philadelphia by the name of Bill Harris. He was featured with the Woody Herman Orchestra. One of the things he was most noted for, perhaps, was a selection that he recorded with Woody's band called Bijou, our version played by Wayne Andre. Thank you. Next on the list, chronologically, I guess, would be the Stan Kenton era. I had the pleasure of playing with Stan's band for a couple of years. One of the numbers I was featured on and recorded with Stan's band was a composition called Collaboration. In the latter part of 1953, I teamed up with a gentleman who's always been one of my very favorite trombone players, by name J.J. Johnson. Together, he and I made many records. One of the ones that did us a lot of good was a show tune written by Cole Porter, It's All Right With Me. Which brings us up to the present time. We like now to give you our version of the contemporary trombone section as a section and a soloist. The members of the trombone section being Carl Fontana, Wayne Andre, and Dick Lieb. Here's an original composition entitled Potpourri.
Thank you.
That was Kay Winding's Trombone Panorama, giving us the history of the trombone and jazz. it's kind of touch and go, hit and miss, but gave them an opportunity to do some good playing. Here's their salute to Count Basie, Louisiana. With a salute to Count Basie, that was Louisiana. Here's a Horace Silver tune done by the trombone group. Kay Winding in the trombones with The Preacher.